Hello, YouTube! So, guess what? I'm going to do a 12-video series on one whole author. Yes, I have a speech problem, okay? Oh yeah, I forgot my introduction. It's PJBottomz! I read it, you review it, we all win. Now, this author's name is Peter Chimaera, I think. I think that's how you pronounce his name. And I decided that the fanfic critic, who is in my other channels, list on my channel, if you're on my channel, it's right down there, she did a whole video on him, because his stories were just that bad. And I thought, well, I'm going to do that too. Now, the only reason that I'm doing 12 videos instead of just one really long video is that I have to record using my webcam, and YouTube won't let me record anything past 15 minutes. So yeah, so I'm gonna go with each video is gonna get, each video is gonna cover one story at a time. And yes, I will be placing a link to the story that I'm reading in the video in the description below here. So I hope you enjoy this. Oh, and I just want to read this on his profile, because this is just so hilarious. Dracula 2010 will be my last book unless there is a lot of demanding. I might probably still write more fanfictions and takes requests, but my sorties are not as so popular anymore, so I will probably be moving onwardly. One thing, who would demand that he keeps writing more books? They suck! Okay? And, anyway, his stories were never popular. They suck. God. I hate people who write horrible stories who think they're so good at writing stories. It's just annoying. Alright. Enough of my ranting. Let's get on to the first one. This is The Simpsons Dinner. It is, written by Peter Chimaera. It's one of 12 stories. It's rated K+. It's in English. It's humor, family. It's Homer, and it has 56 reviews, of which I'm pretty sure they are all very mean. Let's begin. Chapter Oin. Wow, that didn't take long. I mean, come on. It's just Chapter Oin. Oin! Gosh. Alright. Marge had to tell Homer the news. I am glucky that my sisters are coming over to dinner. Glucky. Wow, what a stupid, unimaginative word. Oh, dough. And he dropped his hammer on foot because he was fixing doghouse of sanest little Holper when the big news came, and he was so shocked of anger that he dorked it right on his so much toes. That did not even make sense. Come on, man. You cannot be that stupid. Alright. Chapter 2. And what I don't like about this is that he didn't use the chapter feature. So, I mean, that's why they have a chapter feature. Chapter 2, they come over. Past the onions, no, Selma, and Homer ate so many pork chops that he went, I don't feel so good, and ran to the bathroom. Where did Homer go? It's about the worst sentence ever written by any human. He went to the bathroom, don't call your father Homer, and Maggie creates suck noise and shrugged her shoulders because it was all that Homer's eating. And Maggie creates suck noise. God. Whew, okay. Because it is all about Homer's eating too much all the time. Mr. Burns cammed over and rung the doorbell. Cammed? Doorbelt? What the heck? God, this is horrible. Marge took off her apron. I'll get it. Don't be a hurry. But it turns out at the door, it was Mr. Burns. Oh my gosh, I never would have guessed that, even though you said that Mr. Burns came over and rang the doorbell. I'm doing off-hours performance review, and I need to speech to Homer Simpson's or he gets fired. But he is in bathroom? What a predicament. My God. This story is all over the place. Chapter 3, Homer has to get his job back. Mr. Burns, I missed performance review, but I want to get my old job back. No, it is too late. I have replaced you with Ned F. Semicolon Landers. How would someone work a semicolon into that? Doe. Googly-doo, Mr. Homer. I am working at that power plant you work at. Ho home, Flanders. Ho home. So he's going to ride a ho home? Okaledokalery. That's a interesting word. But he thought it was Mr. Burns telling him and went home, so Dr. Burns had to fire him. Okay. Went first home. 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 Ugh. And then suddenly Mr. Burns became Dr. Burns in one sentence.
Why, I never knew that could happen.
Chapter 4, no title. Ha ha, ha ha, you lost your job. Homer said to Flanders, and they were, and Flanders' house, so he's talking to his house. Who talks to a house? Where they were having barbecue. Oh my God, he can celebrate my barbecue! To celebrate Ned Flanders' birthday. It was a pickle. It was a pickle. And why is it in italics? You're not mad. I'm mad now because you don't use text in a story. When you write an appropriate story, you use the actual word. Sorry. And Homer went home and slammed the door on his foot. Slammed. Must be some new words invented that I must not have gotten the dictionary with. Not again on my foot, and Zelma was still there and laughed at him badly, and so did others like Bumblebee Man, but Peter Graffin did not, since he's on a different show. What does this have to do with Bumblebee Man and Peter Griffin, or in this case, Peter Graffin? You see, this is why people annoy me. If you're gonna write a story, you need to learn names, you need to have spell check on whatever you're using to write it with, and you need to have a plot and not have everything scattered everywhere. God, people annoy me so much. Alright. Well, that's the first of 12 stories by Peter Chimaera, and if you want to review this yourself, there's a link in the description below. So, I'll be back in a few minutes with the next review.